Welcome! Today's program is all about cryptocurrency, blockchain, and gaming.
Crypto Media Service, bringing you in-depth thoughts on cryptocurrencies.
Hello and welcome to Crypto Media Service, the weekly show giving you deep thoughts about cryptocurrencies. Today's program will be all about cryptocurrencies and gaming. Of course, this is a theme that we have had this week, so that we have two articles on the subject. One is our dream, which I will be linking down below. The other one is, well, what projects are out there. Short description of some of the projects which we find most interesting. You will also find the link down below. So let's get into it, cryptocurrency and gaming. Some of the things we don't cover in our article is why gaming will be the ideal place to adopt cryptocurrencies. But if you take gamers are used to virtual currencies, especially online gamers. If you take an online game like Star Trek Online, you can purchase some in-game points for special items. And this will be easy to use as a currency, exchange them to a cryptocurrency. So instead of buying the in-game points, which are specialized for this one game, you will might in the future be able to use cryptocurrencies and just transfer them in to the game once you have decided on what item you want. And the only difference for gamers is they might have to use their mobile phone or something like that in order to facilitate the purchase. But gamers are used to using their mobile phones. Many games has already an app you can use in collaboration with the online game. And of course, this gives you a great opportunity for cryptocurrency adoption. But then we have to move on. We have to move on to blockchain. Blockchain is a way for us to keep track of special items. Or all items in the game, for that matter. Just as long as the developers can add the item to the blockchain. The technique behind this, I will not get into because, well, I understand it, but not good enough to tell it on to others. So once they can put the items on the blockchain, then as soon as you find the item, purchase the item, wins the item, and so on, the blockchain will record it, and you will actually have ownership of this virtual item. And even if you don't play the game for a long while, you'll still have ownership of the virtual item. And you might be able to transfer them between accounts and sell them and all of that. So we also need marketplaces for items to be sold. And they don't necessarily need to be run by the developers. They could actually just develop the items, sell the items to the marketplace, and then a third party would maintain the marketplace. And in that way, we would see that third party intermediaries would be something we can use for these marketplaces, exactly as when you see exchanges. It is not the teams developing the coins that run the exchanges. It is third person, or third party. Sorry about that. And so, once we have established all of this, I believe the gamers actually like that they have ownership of the items instead of they're bound in some account. And if, let's say, the company developers want to ban you, yeah, but you're banned and your items is lost. You might have spent a lot of money on those items. Whereas if you use a blockchain technology, you'll have ownership. So even if you get banned from the game, you can still sell your items on the marketplace, making it that much more a secure to purchase expensive items. This would be win-win for both the companies developing games. It would be win-win for the gamers, and we might see a new industry. And I believe such a platform as Steam would actually be quite good to use for this. It wouldn't take them a little effort, but not much, to set it all up in the Steam store. We already have the selling of trading cards, which is what I have done the most. So there's not far from setting the trading card on sale and buy them to, well, trading in-game items. The only thing here is that if Steam does it instead of some website, then you should be able to have the possibility of selling directly in a dollar or euro amount. That way you would only use the cryptocurrency in the background, and in the foreground you would still have, well, your normal fiat currency. Instead, at least my take on it. You might have another view. I'd like to hear your view. And if you have any good input on this, feel free to comment below. I'd love to hear your input. And if you're watching it on Cryptoms Online or on Steam it, I'm sorry about the delay. I have had a lot of problems with my ISP this week. If you're watching it on YouTube, we managed to get it up on time. So if you like it, click like. If you don't, click dislike. And remember to subscribe for further information when we release new videos on Cryptoms Online and Steam it. It is every Saturday. On YouTube, it is Sunday. And thank you for listening. I hope you have a good week, and see you in a week.